Mrs. Carrington? You wanted to talk to me?
Yes, Tony. Now, you're an excellent groundsman.
Thanks, Mrs. Carrington.
At least that's what I keep telling Mr. Carrington. But you're a little bit loose, misguidedly loose, with your tongue.
My tongue?
Hmm.
I don't know what you mean.
Don't you?
No.
Well, you told Mrs. Carrington, the present Mrs. Carrington, that I was out skeet shooting the day that she fell off her horse.
Oh, that. Yes.
Oh, that. Yes. Well, you were mistaken, weren't you, Tony?
No, ma'am, I wasn't.
I see. Would you like some tea?
No, thank you.
Well, let's change the subject, shall we? To my silver.
Your what?
My silver.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Well, I had an extremely valuable Georgian silver desk set stolen from this studio recently. And in fact, it was the very day that you came here to deliver some flowers to me to paint. I had to go out for a while and I left you here alone. Do you remember, Tony?
Hey, look, if you're accusing me...
Oh, I'm not accusing you of anything. Not yet. But I might just change my mind if you don't explain your faulty memory to the present Mrs. Carrington and tell her just exactly what did or did not happen that day that she fell off her horse.
So you're saying you were mistaken?
Yes, Mrs. Carrington.
I see. Thank you, Tony, for remembering. You can leave now.
Well, I'm certainly glad that that little matter's cleared up. I can't tell you how upset I've been ever since you accused me of doing it. But I want you to know that I forgive you, Krystle, particularly about that little contretemps in my studio.
In my world, we call it a fight. A good, dirty, no-holds-barred cat fight.
Your world. Whatever.
Is that what you call that little incident in Beverly Hills a few years ago with that actress? Did you call that a whatever?
Oh, that. You mean when she slapped me for no apparent reason, so I tore off her wig and threw that and her Oscar through the French windows. It was quite amusing, really. Sort of a cross between a contretemps and a catfight.
Semantics aside, you're going to forgive me, as you were saying.
Oh, yes. Because I realized that losing the baby was something that you could never really recover from. Particularly Fallon having had her baby and Tony giving you this awful misinformation. It must have triggered your irrational moment.
Do you know what I think? I think this is another one of your incredible performances.
Oh, thank you. I attended the Royal Academy for a year. I'm glad it's paid off. So, what shall I do for an encore, as it were?
As it is, you don't have to do anything. You've already played the transparent Alexis to perfection.
Tell me about this play that you're concocting in that little blonde head of yours.
It's really rather ugly. It's about us. You were scared to death I would tell Blake what happened between us. So you tried desperately to cover your tracks.
This is very interesting. Do go on, Mrs. Jennings. Oh, I'm so sorry. Mrs. Carrington.
I haven't told Blake yet what happened between us, Alexis. Because I can't prove that you fired that gun to frighten my horse. In my soul, I know you did. And I warn you, Alexis, I'll never forget what you cost me. Not as long as I live.